Hello everyone. In this video, we going to discuss the female reproductive system in leech. So you know that the leeches are monoecious or hermaphrodites. That is, both male and female reproductive organs are found in one individuals. Though they are hermaphrodites, the self fertilization does not occur. The cross fertilization is the rule. So female reproductive organs, it consists of three different organs. First one is ovisacs and ovaries. Second, oviducts, common oviduct and albumin glands. And third one is the vagina. So we see one by one. First one is ovisacs and ovaries. So like a testes, ovisacs are also true coelomic spaces and remain filled with a colorless coelomic fluid. There is a single pair of ovisacs in the 11th segment, one on either side of the ventral nerve cord. And each ovisac contains a long coil, delicate thread-like ovary. It is formed of a nucleated protoplasm. The two ends of the ovary are swollen and club-shaped. The eggs are budded off from the ovary. The ovary lies floating in the coelomic fluid of the ovisacs. This is the diagram in which here, this is a ovary, ovisacs, in which the ovary is present, thread-like coil, from which the eggs or ova are blooded off. And the duct which is arises from this ovary, which is known as a oviducts. So this is one of the ovisacs. So there is a pair of ovisacs is present in a leech. In this diagram, this is a female reproductive organs in which the pair of ovisacs are seen in 11 segments. In this ovisac, there is a coil like ovary is present. It's a left ovisacs and right ovisacs, and the duct which is arises from this ovisacs unite and form a common duct, and this is a vagina which is present at the posterior end of this 11th segment. Second one is oviducts, common oviduct and albumin glands. From the base of each ovisac arises a short and a slender tube which is called as oviduct. This is shown in this diagram. The duct which is arises from this ovisac is called as this oviduct. The right oviduct passes beneath the ventral nerve cord and unites with the left oviduct to form a common oviduct in the 11 segments. So in this diagram, the oviduct which is arises from the right and left oviducts unite to form a common oviducts in the 11th segments. At this point, the common oviduct is covered with thick layer of unicellular albumin glands. Each albumin gland open into the common oviduct by a fine ductile. The posterior part of common oviduct not covered with albumin glands becomes folded like S and opens into the vagina in the posterior part of the 11th segment. This common oviduct is opens into the vagina. So the third part of this female reproductive organ is the vagina. It is a large pear-shaped muscular bags situated mid-ventrally in the posterior part of the 11th segment. This vagina continues anteriorly in the form of short and narrow tube दिस ट्यूब्स ओपन्स टू आउटसाइड थ्रू अ फेमेल जेनेटल अपर्चर सिचुएटेड मिड वेंट्रली इन द ग्रूव बिटवीन द सेकंड एंड थर्ड एनुला ऑफ द सेगमेंट्स ड्यूरिंग ब्रीडिंग सीजन दिस वजाइना इंक्रीजेस इन साइज एंड इट्स इनर लाइनिंग बिकम्स फोल्डेड. सो दिस रिप्रोडक्टिव ऑर्गन्स फेमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव ऑर्गन्स ओपन्स आउटसाइड द बॉडी थ्रू अ फेमेल जेनिटल अपर्चर विच इज सिचुएटेड एट द सेकंड एंड थर्ड एनुला ऑफ द 11 सेगमेंट्स. देन कोपुलेशन एंड फर्टिलाइजेशन हाउ इट ऑकर्स. सो एज वी सी द सेल फर्टिलाइजेशन डज नॉट ऑकर इन हिरुडिनेरिया दैट इज अ लीच. ओनली द क्रॉस फर्टिलाइजेशन इज ऑकर दैट इज द मेल gametes from one individual and female gametes from another individual, not from a same individuals. So during breeding season, that is the breeding season is March and April, two leeches come in contact through their ventral surfaces as shown in this figure. The two leeches comes in contact with each other. The male genital aperture through the girdle of one individual lies against the female genital aperture of the other individuals. The penis of each leech enters into the female genital aperture of the other leech and they transfer the male gametes into the vagina of the each other. So copulation finishes within an hour and the two leeches separate out. The fertilization of eggs occurs in the vagina and the fertilized eggs are discharged into the cocoon for further development. So this process occurs for an hour. Then cocoon formation. After copulation, the cocoon formation occurs during April, May and June. The clitellar gland situated in the 9th to 11 segments become active during this period. They secrete a several layers thick snow white through the girdle around the clitellar regions of the leech. This is known as a cocoon. The clitoral glands secretes thick albumen within the cocoon. The fertilized eggs are laid in the cocoon through the female genital apertures. The number of eggs in a cocoon varies, but it is never large. The animal now withdraws its head from this cocoon slowly. As it withdraws the prostomial glands from the plugs, first the anterior plug and then the posterior plug, the cocoon formation is completed within 6 hours. So for the copulation, the 1 hour is required, or it occurs up to 1 hours and the cocoon formation is completed within 6 hours. It is laid in moist places by the side of the pond but never in the water. These cocoons are laid in the moist places near the ponds. On coming in contact with air, the cocoon becomes hard. A cocoon is light yellow in color and barrel shape. It is about 25 to 30 millimeter long and 12 to 15 millimeter wide. Its wall is formed of an outer thick spongy layer and an inner thin but tough membrane. Its end remains closed by a plug. It contains a jelly-like albumen and 1 to 24 developing embryos. The young leeches are, after hatching out of the egg, swim in albumen and feed on it. Soon the plugs drop off and the young leeches come out of this cocoon. The development, the cleavage is unequal and development is direct, that is without any larval stage. In those animals, the larval stage includes the development is known as indirect development. But in this case, the larval stage is not occur. So the development is direct development. And the fully developed young leeches come out of the cocoon within 15 days. So this is all about the female reproductive organs, which consist of ovary sacs and ovaries, oviducts, common oviducts, and albumen glands and vagina, ovisacs. So there is a pair of ovisacs. We in the 11th present in the 11th segments, and these ovisacs consist of a ovaries, which is a thread-like coil, delicate, which as shown in this diagram. And this from this left and right ovaries, the oviduct is arises, which unite to form a common oviduct in the 11 segments. Then third part is vagina, which large pear-shaped muscular bag situated mid-ventrally in the 11 segments, and it opens outside the body through a female genital aperture. Then copulation, so the self-fertilization is not occur, cross-fertilization is the rule. The two individuals are come in contact with each other and exchange their gametes. The fertilization of eggs occurs in the vagina. Then cocoon formation, the eggs, fertilized eggs are laid into this cocoons. The development is direct development, and it requires or the fully developed eggs, leeches come out of the cocoon within the 15 days. Thank you.